Next up, is your codex device making you sick? A new study.
8 or 9 rounds. Then we find Hall.
Hold on. We have some breaking news. Reports are flying in about a violent Kree attack on Jabari 5. Millions are feared dead.
Hey, Pete. I found her. I'll see if that drink maker can pour something stronger. We're gonna need it.
We need to talk.
You are the Star-Lord that's caused nothing but trouble for Alla. Are you not? I need your help.
Well, you got a funny way of asking. Most people don't point a gun in my face when they want my help.
Look, My name is Baldin, son of Hala, the Accuser. You've seen what my mother is capable of, the weapon she now has in her possession. You want to stop her, right? Let us work together. No more people have to die.
I'm not helping you with squat until you put the gun down.
Not until you agree to help me.
Yeah, that's the opposite of what I asked for.
I risked my life. Risked treason to my people, just so I could find you and stop my mother from destroying our...
Whoa, whoa, whoa! You guys having a party and it didn't invite me?
Rocket, this is Baldin, Hala's son. He wants to help us.
Wait. Hala's friggin' son? Now, I'm not buying it. The Kree, who've been trying to kill us, need I remind you, don't just offer their help.
I'm not so sure. Think he might actually want to help us.
Listen, I know you were lost in his dreamy eyes, but he ain't fooling me.
But you know, he's probably got valuable intel on Hala, if we knew he was telling the truth.
Maybe I should just go. I'm sorry that I bothered you.
Whoa, not so fast. You're not going anywhere, friend.
Rocket? What are you-
Hang tight, Pete. I'll be back in a jiff.
Mantis? Groot?
Sorry that took so long. She wasn't too keen on coming back here.
Mantis will be able to tell if the kid's lying or not.
This is why you dragged me back? You said it was life or death.
You
just want to use my powers as some sort of lie test.
Hala has a super weapon and is killing innocent people. That's the textbook definition of life or death.
Okay. But what does he have to do with that?
This isn't just some random Kree. This is Hala's son.
I'm Groot?
Your mother is very mean. Okay, I'll help. But I'm doing this for the galaxy, not for you.
Fine. I'll ask the questions. You just tell me if he's lying or not.
Oh, are you done talking about me like I'm not here? Not that being treated like I'm invisible is anything new.
I like you, kid. You might just fit right in around here.
I'm not sure if that's a compliment.
My friend Mantis here is an empath, which means she'll know if you're lying, so... tell the truth. Why did you come here?
It is as I said before. I came here to stop my mother and save my people. The Kree have a mistaken view on superiority. If we were truly great, we would lead by example, not by force.
Well, I'll be damned. I've seen it all. A pacifist Kree.
Yeah, well, the Kree had their shot. They're the ones who screwed it up. You became so preoccupied with war that it ended in the destruction of your planet.
My people, they just need new leadership.
And it sounds like you've got someone in mind for the job.
Oh, I had never really considered it.
Really? You sure you want to go with that, or would you like to try again?
Okay. Maybe I have considered it. I know, as long as Hala continues to lead the Kree, they will never change. And I can't help but feel responsible. My mother, she wasn't always like this. She used to be different.
Oh, yeah. No, I'm sure she was an angel back in the day. Baking treats for the homeless, holding charity drives.
Well, no. She wasn't like that. She was uncompromisingly strict. As a leader and a parent. It was her way or no one's way. I have a proposition. I am Hala's only child. If she thinks you are keeping me hostage, it would emotionally compromise her. She'll become careless. It could give you the advantage you need to defeat her, freeing the Kree from her rule. All I ask in return for my cooperation is when the time comes, you must promise to spare her life.
This is mounds upon mounds of crap. He just wants to use us so he can rule the Kree himself.
Please! There has been enough death!
Okay. You got a deal. You help us take down Hala, and we promise to keep her alive.
Thank you, Star-Lord. Your word is your bond. As is mine.
I'm still gonna be sleeping with one eye open.
I just want a new path forward for my people.
Don't even think about making trouble for us. Let's take a walk back to the ship, pal.
But even with Baldin's help, do we still have a chance? Hala is armed with a devastating weapon, combined with the Forge. There's no stopping her.
I am Groot.
But the Guardians are broken. I don't see a world where you can actually defeat Hala. And when you were together, you all hated each other. I can't imagine a time when you didn't hate each other.
It wasn't all bad, Mantis. We had plenty of good times. Come on, Groot, help me out here.
I am Groot.
What is it?
Man, I'm innocent. You got the wrong guys.
Oh, you mean to tell me there's another rodent and tree duo out there?
Yes!
Who were scanned and ID'd by several bystanders.
I am Groot.
Yes, yes, we know who you are.
Forget it, Groot. These bucketheads can't understand you. Don't worry. I know how to handle this. As soon as they lock us up, I'm gonna go up to the biggest, baddest dude in there and knock him out. Oh, boy.
Hey!
I did not know this was an animal prison, too. I am Groot. And I am Drax the Destroyer. Do not attempt to challenge me. I will tear you limb from limb, or snout from tail, whichever would be more painful.
I challenged you. I'm still here.
That is because you cheated! You had a weapon, and I did not.
You take it easy. Knock it off! All right. Make room for one more.
Hey, don't get too comfortable. We'll be back to take you to permanent lockup soon.
Who is this loser?
Call me Star-Lord. I'm sure you've all heard of me. Especially you.
I am Groot.
You said it, pal.
Nice to meet you, Groot. What kind of tree are you? Spruce? Elm?
I am Groot.
Yeah, you already said that.
Hmm.
I could tell you guys are the real badasses in the room. Legendary outlaws like me.
Oh.
Not you. We're too good looking to stay locked up in here. Don't you think? The second the Nova Corps start running background checks on us, none of us are ever gonna see the sweet light of day again.
I am Groot.
And I'm still Star-Lord. Look, so here's the deal. We're breaking out of here.
I'm not going anywhere with any of you.
Settle down in there! All of you!
I will not settle! No prison can contain me.
I'll go gladly if this giant ass won't be there.
My ass is the correct proportion for my body. I am Groot.
Fighting isn't gonna get us anywhere. We need to work together.
Hate to admit it, Stash Lord is right. We're fighting the wrong people.
I just came up with a brilliant plan that's totally original. I'm calling
it... Wait to hear this.
The Great Escape. You see that guard there? He's the only one with the key card to get us out of here. But there's no way we can get to it. So we gotta escape another way. There's a force field all around us, but not below us. And that's where you come in, Muscle Man.
I agree to this nickname.
You are gonna use those beefy mitts of yours to dig us a tunnel to the other side of the force field.
Beefy mitts?
You don't have anywhere to hide all the debris, so this tree, well, you're gonna have to eat it all. And once we're over there, that's where...
Is that you, Rooks?
I'm not gonna lie. A couple of you might die. But know that I will never forget you. Or... we could just use the key card. I love this tree. I think this is the beginning of a beautiful friendship.
Escape. You were going to say escape.
Friendship. I was going to say friendship, but escape will do.
I was wrong about you guys. There's a reason you all ended up together. I never knew. You're not a team, or a family, or friends in the conventional sense.
Yeah. It was all the mustache.
Peter, I don't think that's it.
I don't know, Mantis. I really think it was the mustache.
It was not the mustache.
Okay, fine. It was just a lot of different things that led to us being a great team. We're the guardians of the galaxy. It's time we start acting like it.
Then let's go get them back.
I am Groot! I am Groot!
Nice of you three to show up.
Okay. Just gotta find Gamora.
It's anyone's guess where she is. She's still an assassin. She'll know where to go if she don't want to be found.
Mantis, you were able to track down the shrine using your abilities. Do you think you could find one of us too?
I can usually only sense someone who is nearby. But I may be able to extend my range with your help.
I am Groot.
I have an idea!
What?
You're going to love it!
Huh?
Where are we?
You and I have merged minds.
This is inside my mind. It seems kind of empty.
I've never shared this with anyone before. And you didn't die or anything. This is amazing! I wasn't sure it would work, but it did.
Next time, would you mind giving me a heads up first?
Oh, I'm sorry. I just got a little excited. This island here represents your subconscious mind, Peter. And those other islands represent your friends. Gamora could be anywhere in the galaxy by now. In order to find her, we'll need to build a bridge.
Bridge?
Yes, a bridge of feelings. I won't be able to do it myself. I'll need your help.
Okay. Let's get this party started.
It'll be fun. If we can reach your friends' islands, we'll learn where they are. Now, I need you to concentrate very hard. When you think about the Guardians, what emotions do you feel the strongest?
Whoa, what the hell was that?
On this plane, emotions are able to take physical form. Those are memories that you can connect to with your feelings. If we focus on your emotional relationships with the rest of your team, they will be easier to find.
I can get her back, Pete. If we charge the forge, we can revive Lila.
I can get her back, Pete. If we charge the forge, we can revive Lila.
Who's gonna keep us from falling apart?
You're doing well, Peter. I'm beginning to sense Gamora.
This is my chance, Peter, to protect my new family.
That's curious. Your bond with Drax is very strong.
But I don't understand. You can sense Drax, but Drax is dead.
I can't explain it. But I can certainly feel his presence through your emotions. You've told me how you feel about the Guardians. That's good. But in order to find your friends, I'll need more. How do you think your friends feel about being Guardians?
We're gonna sell Thanos' body!
This is my hour of honor. My sweet wife and daughter have finally been avenged.
This is very unsettling, but please keep trying.
We all stay because... Honestly, we all stay because of you. Peter.
You're doing great.
I didn't think I was actually capable of feeling this many emotions. I'm so deep.
Let's just try once more. You and the Guardians have had so many amazing adventures. How would you describe your happiest moment with them? I think that's enough. If you explore all these memories, we should have what we need to build our bridges.
Hey, I was surrounded by adoring fans. I was surrounded by adoring fans. I couldn't let them go thirsty.
It seems you have many cheerful emotions towards Rocket.
That's the bridge. Makes sense. Rocket's been here the whole time.
In spite of everything you've been through, Rocket cares about you a great deal. He must really value your friendship to remain at your side.
I'm glad he stuck around. He's a good friend.
I suspect that is why he stayed. He knows how well you two get along, how much you need each other.
So, I know where Rocket is, but what's with all these other light orb thingies?
They represent your feelings, Peter. You should explore them.
Drax the Destroyer has purpose once again!
Yes. Drax is back.
If Drax is somehow still out there, your feelings can lead us to him.
This is... What the hell does this mean, Mantis?
It means Drax is alive! And it means you left him for dead. Poor Drax! He must be so lonely!
No. No, there is no way he could have survived back there.
Apparently there is. This proves that he's alive. We wouldn't be able to locate him otherwise.
The others will be so excited that he's still alive.
His sacrifice caused so much turmoil. Hopefully this will repair what was broken in your team.
Okay, we know where Drax is.
But we're not done here. Keep looking.
I still can't believe we did it. Thanos is gone.
You must be very close to Gamora. You've shown many positive emotions for her.
I know this place. I've been here. This is Thanos' training room from Gamora's memory.
Gamora hated her father. Why would she go back?
Maybe because it's the only home she's known. She never stuck around anywhere before she joined the Guardians.
To be alone in the world. It's not easy. Rocket stayed with us, so that island will probably show us the Milano. I'm proud of you, Peter. You did well connecting with your emotions. I know it couldn't have been easy for someone such as yourself. Not everyone can connect with people as easily as I can.
Wait, what the hell is that supposed to mean?
Don't worry, Peter. This is a safe space.
It doesn't feel very safe. So, guess we just have to pick him up.
Who should we get first?
Let's go grab Drax.
Let's go!
Hell out of town.
Don't worry. If Drax is alive, I got money on that thing being dead. Whoa. He actually did it.
Drax! Holy crap! You did that worm! You came out of it! Like, you were inside it, and then you came out? That's amazing!
You doubted me, Peter Quill?
Yes! I mean, no! Maybe! I mean, that worm was freaking huge!
I suppose your doubt is understandable. The creature did not give up easily. Our battle raged for hours. I felt proud. But I think I was happier butchering that hideous worm than when I got revenge on my daughter's killer. How could that be? I cannot find a reason for it. That worm has no importance to me.
Revenge doesn't bring you happiness. It just delays the pain a while. It's about what you want, not what you need.
That is incredibly wise. I am not used to hearing such wisdom from you, Peter. In the midst of battle, I felt such exhilaration and nothing else. I spared not a single thought for Kamaria. I think I am afraid that with each passing moment, her memory will continue to disappear. I fear that once I forget, Kamaria will die a second death. These feelings will not stop. I do not know how to proceed.
I don't think that's true at all. Your memories of your family will last forever. Kamaria will always be a part of you.
That is impossible. She is not a part of me. She is dead! I am not used to being afraid of anything. Oh, if only I were dead. These feelings would not cause me such distress. No matter how hard I try.
Okay, I know you wanted to die, but that kind of attitude, it's not healthy. You need to give up on this ridiculous death wish.
Death is the only solace I thought I could find. I was not completely honest with you before. I did wish to protect the Guardians. But part of me hoped that I might see my daughter again in the afterlife. If such a thing does exist, I do not know.
The Forge hasn't been destroyed. We can get it back, and you can see Kamaria again. You know, without dying.
Yes. That would give me a reason to not be dead. Thank you, my friend. I feel more sure of my path forward.
Hey guys, it's all clear. Bring the ship down.
Now, let us return to your garbage heap of a ship. The galaxy is counting on us to stop Hala. And I have wasted enough time beside this rotting carcass.
Yeah, well, it's what's on the inside that counts.
The inside is also atrocious.
How dare you?
All right. Huh.
You expecting any calls today?
Star-Lord! You must know why I am contacting you. Admit it!
Sorry. I don't recognize this number. Who is this?
You know who this is! Hala, the Accuser! You have taken Baldin hostage. And I want him back. I do not know how you did it, but I want him back, now!
I want the Eternity Forge back in my hands. You return that to me, you get your son.
You think I will just forfeit it to you? Absolutely not.
Mother!
Well, look who it is.
Please, Mother, just do as they ask.
What are you planning to do with him? If you harm him in any way, I will repay it 1,000-fold to you.
Well, that all depends on you. If you don't want anything bad to happen to your son...
No one threatens me!
I just did.
You are the most infuriating person I have ever encountered. I have always heard of the insolence of human beings. But meeting them in person is infinitely worse.
Yeah, I get that a lot.
I am coming for you. I shall destroy Nowhere. Then I will continue to Earth. There will be no home for you to run to.
She hung up on me. I can't believe she hung up on me.
You're unbelievable, Quill.
It seems you possess a unique ability. I've never seen anyone annoy my mother so much before. I fear she cannot be stopped. If you don't stand against her, no one will.
Yeah, not gonna lie. That conversation could have gone better.
You think?
If she's coming from Nowhere, we've got to hustle.
Keep the engine running. I'll be back soon.
Don't you think Gam's gonna be a little pissed at you? And what are you gonna say?
I'm sure I'll think of something in the moment.
Word of advice, Pete. Think harder.
Gamora?
You've got some nerve, following me here of all places. I told you I was done. I'm not in a very charitable mood, Peter. Leave, or I'll make you leave.
Or are you here to fight? I won't go easy on you.
Oh, come on. You wouldn't hurt me.
Oh, really?
Whoa! You said you'd keep everyone together! Hala is more powerful than ever. Drax is dead!
Drax isn't dead!
What? Why didn't you open with that? Drax is alive?
Oh, sorry I didn't get the chance to mention it in the 2 seconds before you freaking attacked me!
He was devoured by that thing. You said he was gone.
I thought he was, but he's not! He killed that space worm and is now hanging on the Milano with everyone else. Drax is back to his, well, his normal self.
Ah!
What?
Ugh, I just don't get it. Why does everything just work out for you? No matter what you do, everything just conveniently works out for the great Star-Lord.
It's just part of my Star-Lord charm, I guess. Just too good looking to be unlucky. Oh,
you are incorrigible.
So Drax happened to survive, but you told him to sacrifice himself, knowing full well that it could kill him. Can't you even pretend to be bothered by that? Show me something. Anything!
You're asking if I feel bad? Of course I feel bad!
Then why won't you show it?
Hey, what do you want from me? You want me to wander around crying? That isn't my style, Gamora.
You shrug through everything, free of consequence, while I feel punished for merely existing.
I've done so many horrible things. I fought. I tortured a little girl. All because I was too scared to stand up to Thanos. And now, my sister is dead. I'll never be able to forgive myself. You made a mistake coming back, Peter.
You were as much of a victim as Nebula was. But Thanos is to blame. Not you.
Thanos may have given the order, but the blade was in my hand. Rocket pushes people away to hide his pain. Drax revels in his rage. But I don't know how to get past it. All the lives I've ruined. I've hurt so many people. Despicable acts I did to serve Thanos.
Well, no matter how much it hurts, we have to soldier on. Our job is to make sure the good outweighs the bad.
If that's the job, I failed long ago. I don't even know why you bothered coming here.
You're my rock. You're also the only one who gets my jokes. I can't do this without you.
I close my eyes at night, and I'm right back here. I'm that frightened girl, unsure of what or who to trust. I want nothing more than that pain to be over.
Why don't you trust me then? Let me share that burden with you. Carrying the weight of the world on your shoulders and not feeling like you're making it any better. I feel that too.
I'm just so... so tired.
Hey, Drax. Surprised to admit it, I'm actually glad to see you.
I too am glad you have not perished in a violent and agonizing way. Perhaps by sudden evisceration or Bylanese organ chewing. I once saw a man have his organs chewed.
Yep. Definitely the same old Drax.
Absence does make the heart grow fonder, unfortunately.
Welcome home, everyone.
I am Groot!
Groot says it's so good to see you all.
Look at you, Peter. Somehow you managed to get us all back in the same room. I didn't think we'd see each other after last time. Unless, you know, we ended up in the same prison. Again.
We kind of made a mess out there. Now we gotta clean it up.
We?
Okay, some of us made it more than others. Now, I wish I had better news for you, but, things have turned into a galactic war zone out there.
Yes. Hala has begun killing innocent people to resurrect her army.
And she's coming after us next.
Hala has the Forge, her son, and an unlimited army. Yet she still considers us a threat?
Actually, that's a long story. Baldin, come say hi.
Hello,
You have taken her son prisoner! You are not the pathetic warrior I so often think you to be.
I was not kidnapped. I am here to help.
Baldin is here to help us. He's a good guy. He promised to play bait for us to lure out Hala.
Whatever stops her from what she's about to do, the killing, it can't go on like this.
This does give us emotional leverage.
But we still have not gained any tactical advantage since the last time we fought her.
Hala is heading for nowhere. For us. I'm open to suggestions on how we approach this.
Well, you've been on her ship before. I can analyze the readings from last time and see if there's a way to take out her weapons. When in doubt, look to the data. There's gotta be a weak spot or two we can exploit.
If Hala's ship has a weakness, I know you'll be able to find it.
Flattery will get you everywhere, Pete. I'll do my best.
Hala isn't going to go easy on us. We'll have to prepare to take her down.
I'll be on the bridge, Pete. Come talk to me when you get the chance.
I am Groot.
Thanks, Groot. Hey, Gamora.
Hey. I wanted to thank you again. What you said back at that training hall, I really appreciate it. If you hadn't have shown up when you did, I don't know what might have happened.
Well, thanks for not killing me.
Oh, come on. I wasn't actually going to kill you.
Yeah, you could have fooled me.
So, what was on your mind?
So, I think that we should, you know, maybe talk. Just to talk about, you know, you and me. I mean, I just care for you a lot.
I know.
Oh, you do. Okay. So how do you feel?
Peter, I just maybe.
Yeah. Yeah, of course. Yeah, sure. Yeah, we'll just put a pin right in it. Just That's the pin going in the, yeah. Just for later.
Quill, I was waiting for you. I wish to apologize.
For what?
I realize I have not been the same since we slew Thanos. I was so consumed in my emotions that I uselessly sacrificed myself. My selfish act put the Guardians at risk. For that, I am deeply sorry, and I hope you can accept my sincere apology.
You have nothing to apologize for, Drax.
Perhaps on Earth, selfishness is commonplace, but on Kylos, it is most shameful. I will try to redeem myself once again in the coming battle against Hala.
You ready for one last battle?
I do not believe this will be our last battle, but for Hala, it will be.
So, that giant space worm, how'd you kill it?
It is a heroic tale that people will talk about for generations. I launched myself into the jaws of the worm creature, narrowly avoiding endless rows of teeth. I used my blades to slow my descent, shredding the creature's pulsating throat. Once within its noxious bowels, I detonated the drive cores of 6 dead ships. The explosion resulting from digestive fumes and flammable fecal matter was the most beautiful sight I have ever seen.
How the hell did you get out of there?
Peter, some may not know this, but when a creature is in its death throes, the sphincter relaxes. I was forced to swim through bile. Gland juices seeped into my nose and mouth until I emerged, moist, reeking, victorious. I look forward to repeating this tale many, many times for the others.
I'm sorry we left you for dead.
I do not blame you for your ineptitude. I also thought I was bound to die. It was a reasonable misunderstanding.
Later, Drax.
What happens later? I am Groot.
Listen, I wasn't stuck. I was just waiting for my dramatic entrance.
What you got cooking?
Yeah, about that. I've been poring over the scans we got last time and we hit the Revenant. Good news is, I know what we gotta do to take Hala down. Bad news is, I don't know how we're gonna do it. We're gonna have to disable that super gun of hers if we want any chance of beating this. Simple, right? No more gun, no more dead people.
Huh. Is that all? And here I was thinking it was gonna be something difficult.
Yeah, laugh it up, smartass. Right, so far as I can tell, there's a number of key points on the ship to factor in. Here, 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 and here. That's as far as I've gotten.
Okay, so lay it on me.
What do you want to know?
Huh. This place looks important.
Yeah, that's the computer core, where the ship's system can be accessed. We need someone to hack into the computer. It's vital in getting that weapon offline.
What's this?
The main hull system. You might not remember, but it was filled with those cryopods. And because somebody charged up the Eternity Forge, all those dead Kree are now alive Kree and will need to be dealt with. Big old hallway like this? Great place for a distraction.
What's this one?
Those are the access ways to the computer core. Kind of like the hard drive for the ship. If someone don't cover those access ways, reinforcements will be sent straight to the core and overwhelm the hacker in no time.
Is that the weapon?
Right. I've actually got a plan for this one. It's got a couple of points on the outside of the ship where the energy is focused before it discharges. But get this. These points aren't guarded. They're just out there in the open. Probably because the Kree don't think anyone's insane enough to attack a super weapon head on.
Guess someone got careless. We're gonna have to teach him a lesson.
Yeah, and I got just the guy for the job.
Wait, what? Me?
You're the one with the jet boots. I got a slew of homebrewed explosives and deflectors. You'll plant the explosives on each of those energy points, and then when Hala fires the weapon again, boom! It'll blow itself up.
And what if they fire the weapon before I'm done planting the deflectors?
Just finish before that happens. We need our hacker to take down the shields and clear a way for you to plant the explosives. Someone to guard that hacker from any attacking Kree, and a third person to stage a distraction to keep them occupied. But as far as plans go, it's pretty insane. And,
suicidal?
Yeah, that word.
Ah, this is my favorite kind of plan. It's got all the adjectives.
Mine too. Oh, I almost forgot. We need someone to grab Hala's helmet. Won't be able to trigger the weapon without it. It's probably in her quarters somewhere. So someone will have to steal it right out from under her nose.
That sounds like you're volunteering, Rocket.
Oh, yeah. Tell the 40-pound guy to steal the helmet off a Kree accuser. Be serious, Pete.
All right. I'll pick who does what. Hacker, protector, distractor, helmet thief, and me.
Yeah, and if all that don't work,
Guess we'll just have to resurrect this guy and have him chop Hala's ships to pieces.
Good one.
That could actually work. If the forge contains enough power. And if we could reacquire it.
Well, we'll call that plan B.
When in doubt, let magic save the day. You had me worried back there, Groot. Thought you were mad at me or something.
I am Groot.
Hey, Pete.
Are you sure this plan is gonna work?
Nope. But I'm okay with that this time. You guys got my back, and that's all I need.
I've got a role in mind for you, Rocket.
Oh, yeah?
I want you to hack the computer.
Logical choice. I won't let you down.
You and Groot make up? Is the Dream Team back together?
Yeah, we sat down and talked it out. I think we both said stuff we regretted. But we're good now.
I am Groot.
Back at you, buddy.
Catch you in a bit.
You know, if this doesn't go our way, I just want to tell you...
I am Groot. I am Groot.
If we're going to attack the Revenant, we all need a job to do. You're gonna be on protection duty.
I am Groot.
Good call, Quill. Groot's always had my back, and I ain't even been shot once. Not once!
I'll see you around, buddy.
I am Groot. I am Groot.
Really? Pete got in touch with his feelings? That actually worked?
I am Groot.
You still owe me 50 units from our last sparring practice.
So, Rocket has this plan?
A just crazy enough to work one?
Yeah, the usual kind.
Not surprised. So what role do I play in this disaster?
You're sneaky. So... why don't you stealth down there and steal Hala's helmet?
Her helmet? All right. Sounds like a challenge. Leave it to me, Peter.
See you in a bit. Hey, Drax. We've got a plan of attack ready to go. I've just got to divvy up the roles.
Of course. I trust you will grant me the most important job.
We need someone to cause a distraction in the main hall and keep the Kree at bay. You think you can handle that?
My friend, if you need Kree to be killed, I will gladly kill them for you.
Pete, looks like Hala just entered the system. We're gonna have to hurry.
It's now or never. All right, guys, bring it in. So, here's the plan. We're making a run on Hala's ship to take that super weapon offline. I've assigned each of you an important role. Hacker, backup, distraction, and of course someone to steal that helmet. I will install the explosive so when the trigger's pulled, the gun blows up right in Hala's face.
This will require everyone to work together flawlessly. I do not believe I have seen that happen. Ever. Are you sure this plan will work?
Yeah, we ain't exactly got a stellar track record when it comes to plans going our way.
I trust each and every one of you to do what you do best. Now, things will go wrong, they always do. But we'll figure it out as we go. We have everyone we need to do that right here.
Uh-oh, here comes a patented Quill speech.
I mean, look at Rocket.
Damn it! I should not have drawn attention to myself.
There's nothing that you can't fix. I've seen you make technological miracles out of a handful of trash. Literal trash! I mean, that's amazing.
Peter, over here. It's me, Drax, the Destroyer.
I volunteer to go next.
Oh, I could never forget you, big guy.
Do not hold back. Tell me what I am.
A perfect murdering machine who, despite all odds, has become more bloodthirsty than ever before.
You are too kind, Peter. I am getting emotional.
And...
Don't.
And Gamora.
Peter.
The woman I love.
Peter.
The woman I like.
Peter.
The woman I would like to love if she were maybe open to that sort of thing. Don't answer that right now.
And what about Mantis?
What about me?
Our newest and most peculiar friend.
We are friends? I have friends? Thank you, Peter!
And last, but certainly not least, Groot.
I am Groot.
The perfect plant. Strong, resilient, self-watering.
I am Groot.
Everything you could ask for, and more. Sure, we have our differences, but we all share something in common.
Arrest records.
Trust issues.
I am Groot.
Dependency on oxygen-rich atmospheres to survive.
Not exactly. Because when it comes right down to it, we are all we've got. Life has taken a lot from us, but we're all still here. As long as we have each other, we can beat anything. Hala doesn't stand a chance.
That was actually a good speech. Except for that love interest thing.
Yes! Everyone is feeling inspired.
Then let's rock and roll.
Peter, before you came back for me, I was ready to give up on the Guardians, because I thought you already had. Thanks for proving me wrong. That is a lot of ships. Here's hoping everything works out. We deserve it happening to us at least once.
Stay on your guard. Be ready for anything.
I always am.
Look sharp, guys. Hala's coming in hot.
I am Groot?
No, I ain't a traitor. It's a phrase. You know, like, she's right on top of us.
I am Groot.
Yeah, that does sound worse. Hang on, rubble coming your way. I'm almost to the computer.
I am Groot.
Hey, exercise is hard for me, okay?
Quill, what happened? Did you die again?
Nope. Totally alive.
Fly on, human.
Guys, how's it going in there?
I'm all hacked in. Plus an added bonus. Her computer's now transmitting some of your music to the entire ship. They're hearing that trash over the air intercoms.
Okay, Pete, you're good to go. Eject it and plant the bomb.
One down.
Star-Lord, how is your mission proceeding?
It's going great. It's going less great. About to have some company. Gotta hurry. If they fire that weapon now, I'm hosed. How's that protection going, Groot?
you hanging up now. Heads up!
Oh, too late.
It's quick.
How's it going in there, Peter?
I'm on the last station now. Now would be a solid time for that distraction.
I have not forgotten. There is an intercom button here. I shall press it. Greetings to all pathetic Kree warriors on this ship. This is Drax the Destroyer. I am waiting for you in the main hallway. Please come see me immediately. Peter, I believe I have gotten their attention.
Well, looks like that got everyone's attention. Oh, no, you don't. Kinda busy here. Thank you. Rocket, all charges are planted. Impressed?
Marginally. Once one of the Kree fires that weapon, the whole ship's gonna go, holy crap, that's a huge explosion.
Yeah, I think that distraction worked a little too well. There are no more Kree on the bridge.
What? Looks like someone just volunteered to go hit that button then.
Do I have to do everything myself?
I managed to get the helmet. Now what, Rocket?
Launch it out an airlock.
Wait a minute. You never actually needed the helmet, did you?
Nope! But now Hal is gonna be looking for it, and it'll be spinning through space!
Rocket?
What?
Oh, come on!
I am Groot.
What do you mean Hala's heading for the bridge? Hey Pete, you better get ready.
Here we go. How do you like that?
This ends now.
Bring it.
I am Groot!
Nice one.
I do not need a weapon to kill you. Do you not see? This is the end. Everything you have done is futile. Admit it. You have been defeated.
Kids can't.
is not over!
Thanks for wanting to do this, baby. Can't imagine being in some sterile hospital. Missing out on this view.
Just take it easy while we're out here, okay? I'm worried about you.
I won't scare you like that again, I promise. That means you'll have to drive us back. You, me, the stars. This is my happy place. Hey, you want to build it back up a bit?
Can I use the lighter fluid?
Come on. That's for amateurs. Don't let it burn out. Hey, how else are we going to roast marshmallows? There you go. You've almost got it.
Huh. Didn't even have to use the lighter fluid.
Well done. No missing eyebrows for you tonight. Fire's looking low, hon. You wanna build it back up a bit?
The fire looks fine to me.
Wait, what? It's practically out. That's strange. I could have sworn I...
Mom.
I shouldn't have brought you out here. I just wanted one last weekend with you. It was reckless.
No matter what happens, I'm glad we came.
I'm sorry, Peter. I just didn't want you to forget who I really was. I don't want you to remember me like that, okay?
You'll always be my mom. I could never forget that. I love you.
Now, why don't you build up that fire a little bit, huh? It's starting to get low.
Mom.
Feel so alive.
We're happy for you, Drex, but I think I can smell my fur burning.
Stay sharp. We don't know where...
This is not over.
Oh my God. How are you not dead yet?
I will gladly fix that.
Where is my son?
I'm right here.
Baldin!
It would bring me immense joy
to spill your son's blood.
Your move, Hala. If you need suggestions, dropping your weapon might be a good place to start.
Dust! You may have destroyed my ship and stolen the Eternity Forge, but I still have my armada surrounding us. Unless you have a weapon that can destroy all of them, I still have the advantage. What are you doing?
What are you doing?
Hey, you're not serious.
For once, he does not look like he is joking.
Well, that's where you're wrong, Hala. I do have a super weapon.
Where?
You're standing inside it.
Accuser! The Celestial! It seems to be reacting. What are your orders?
Continue firing!
You have to stand down!
Stand down? Ugh. You have turned my own blood against me! He has forgotten what it means to be Kree.
Me? I am thinking clearly. You are out of control.
Malden is trying to save you. To save all of you.
And what do you think I have been doing? For years, I have revived our civilization from the ashes. And I will lead them to glory once again. We were born into war. We are not afraid of one Celestial.
Star-Lord, listen to me! Let me lead the Kree instead!
You? Lead the Kree? Don't be ridiculous, Baldin! You are much too naive!
Under my rule, the Kree would have a chance at normal lives! Instead of being in perpetual war!
War is normal! It is in the blood of all beings, whether they admit it or not!
Death only brings more death!
I am Groot!
Your weakness will corrupt our people and lead to their downfall!
Everyone deserves a second chance, and that starts with Baldin. He should lead the Kree.
Thank you.
How dare you! I refuse to hand my title over to a child! The thought is preposterous!
Surely letting me take command of the Kree is preferable to our extinction!
This is the deal, Hala. Step down, or watch an angry Celestial head obliterate your armada. Take it or leave it. You know the consequences. This isn't a we're not so different you and I moment. In fact, we are very different. I don't believe killing others is the only way to get ahead in this world. That's not my style.
I hope I am wrong about you, Star-Lord. You have my surrender. This is Hala, the Accuser. All ships stand down. I have surrendered my title to my son, Baldin. He shall lead the Kree.
The Accuser has surrendered? How is that? Cease fire! All ships stand down!
You had the power to eliminate all Kree, but you showed mercy instead. I will not forget this. I know I have no right to ask for one more favor, but I would like to take my mother into custody.
She killed my sister. She blew up a planet. Hala must face justice for her crimes.
Do what you will. It does not matter to me anymore. I have lost. The judgment is yours.
Please, she is one of our own. My first order as leader will be to see her punished.
You can have her. Just see to it that her sentence fits her crime.
I will. Thank you. My people owe you a great debt they can never repay. It will be a long road, but I will show the galaxy that the Kree can be trusted from now on. Not feared.
Well, if you're looking for some form of payment, I mean, units and booze will work.
I will take that under advisement. For generations, my people will tell the legend of what happened this day.
Of Hala out of my mind. She looked so broken. Lost. We did the right thing, didn't we?
I really don't know, Gamora.
I guess there's no going back now. We did all that we could. I think I could use a drink.
I am Groot.
Yeah. Let's go. Guys still open?
If there's booze on the shelf, they're open.
Hey! Can I come out now? Is it over?
Yes. You can stop cowering like a baby.
And we're all pretty thirsty.
I know now isn't the best time, but, you still haven't paid your tab.
Are you kidding me?
Oh! Oh, you know what? I left my wallet in my other red leather jacket. So...
Yeah. My bar wouldn't even be here if it weren't for you. Just consider your tab forgiven, okay?
What is this? It tastes terrible!
I am Groot?
Tastes like victory.
Victory tastes like burning.
All right. Fill her up.
Actually, the forge is already full. There's still a charge in it, but its power is fading. It can only be used for one more revival. I'm sorry. It won't be able to bring back all your loved ones.
I am Groot.
Groot says you should use the forge for your mom.
I am Groot.
Since you got us back together.
I am Groot.
Wait. What about you guys? I mean, you all lost someone close to you.
The forge was severely damaged when you crashed the Revenant into nowhere. If you wish to use it, you need to do it now.
I'm not sure I need it anymore. Then again, Drax lost his daughter. Seems pretty important to bring her back.
Yes, but the cyborg was Gamora's true kin. It should be her.
For the thousandth time, her name's Nebula.
Yes, the cyborg Nebula.
Thank you, Drax. What about Lila? You loved her.
Guess I'm done being the selfish one. Really, Drax, it should be you!
It should be you!
After everything we've been through, are we seriously still arguing?
No, we're just agreeing strongly. This is an anti-argument. I just got one of those voices. It always sounds like I'm angry.
Oh, yeah, I guess so.
There isn't much time left. The forge is dying. If you wish to use it, you need to do it now.
Thank you.
Mom. I'd like to see my mom again.
I'd really like to meet her.
Take my hand. I want you to think of your fondest memory of your mother. The moment when you were the happiest.
It's me.
Peter? Peter! I don't understand. You're here. I'm here. How is that even possible?
I'll explain everything. I promise. Even the part where I died.
Peter... Look at you. You're so tall. I mean, you're all grown up. And what the hell are you wearing? That jacket. It's ridiculous.
This might come as a surprise, but I'm a legendary space adventurer now.
You always did love outer space and Indiana Jones. So, I guess you combined your passions. I don't know where to begin. I missed so much, so many years. I'm sorry, Peter. I wish I could have been there for you. I didn't want to leave you. To think you had to grow up all on your own,
You can't blame yourself. You were sick. Sometimes life deals you a bad hand.
Well, I feel fine now. Confused, a little weirded out, but generally fine.
I think you're gonna love it here. I'll show you around my spaceship. You can see the stars out of every window.
We're in outer space? Right now?
Yeah. You might need one of these.
Oh, yes. Yes. Thank you. Oh! Peter. Who are all these people staring at me?
These are my friends. And my family. And my team. All rolled into one. That's Gamora, Rocket, Groot, Drax, and Mantis.
Hi.
Nice to meet you, Star-Lord's mom.
Star-Lord?
Yeah. So?
Like the character I made up about you for our bedtime stories? Little Petey, the Star-Lord and his cosmic adventures?
Your mother is embarrassing you with secrets from your childhood. Little Petey! Oh, this will never not be funny.
Well, I guess my secret's out. Now you know everything.
Yeah, what else you got? Someone get this woman a drink. I want to hear more stories like that.
After all the pain it's caused, I'm glad to see its power used for something good. The Forge no longer holds any power over me. I don't know what to do now that I am finally free of it. My life was so entwined with its purpose. With it gone, I feel okay.
We could always use an empath on the team. Why don't you join the Guardians? Officially.
Really?
Definitely.
Thank you, Peter. It will be nice to have a home instead of a box. My head finally feels clear. Thank you, Peter, for all you've done.
So, everything worked out in the end.
Don't you know? Everything works out for me.
Shut up. You know what I mean. I'm proud of you, Peter.
Yeah?
You kept us together after all. I had many, many doubts it would happen. So many doubts. Oh, daily doubts. I honestly couldn't count them all.
I mean, I didn't exactly do it on my own.
I'll take some credit.
Yeah, some. A bit. A tiny bit.
Oh, never change, Peter. How about a refill?
My hero.
Hey, you two seriously need to tell us when there's a toast happening.
I drink this toxic liquid in honor of the galaxy. May it stay guarded.
Oh yeah, I just got here.
What about to new friends? I've never had them before.
I've got a better one. To vacation!
I am Groot.
Yeah, okay. Family's a good one too. Hurry up, Pete. My arm's getting tired.
To guarding the galaxy. I hope we never have to do it again.
At least for a little while.
Ah, nothing says success like finally being lazy.
Guardians, this is the Nova Corps. We have another situation. You have to help us. You're the first ones we called.
Yeah. Good luck with that.